Kirby's return to Dreamland is a return in more ways than one for the puffy protagonist, but is it a dream come true for gamers, or a total nightmare? Life in Dreamland is suddenly interrupted when a large spaceship crash lands on Popstar. Kirby, being the good Samaritan he is, offers to help repair the ship and get its owner back home. It's a simple, easy-to-understand plot, but there's more than one twist to discover in the late-game narrative. But like most first-party Nintendo games, the story doesn't bother to get too much in your way. No, it's the gameplay that keeps people coming back to Nintendo, and Return to Dreamland is no exception. Many of Kirby's latest games have kept him in the platformer format, but experimented with the basic mechanics. Here, Kirby finally reclaims his trademark copy ability, which allows him to mimic the powers of certain enemies. However, there's more to each power than first meets the eye. All of your abilities offer plenty of different attacks to play around with, and like a fighting game, studying the moveset adds a whole new level of intricacy to the experience. For those who want to hone their skills even further, various challenge rooms are unlocked in the visitor's spaceship by collecting a certain number of energy spheres, which are scattered about the levels. These spheres also unlock mini-games, as well as various copy ability rooms where you can try out all the powers and practice using them on your own schedule. Collecting said spheres can be a bit of a headache though. Especially in the later levels, there are puzzles guarding them that cut off access if you're not fast enough. Most of these can be reattempted if you leave the room and enter again, but there are many other scenarios that force you to either die or restart the entire level if you want another chance. This time around, Kirby also has access to Ultra Powers, which are super beefed up versions of his normal skills, capable of wiping the entire screen clear of enemy resistance. They're exactly as cool as they sound, and whenever you find one, you'll also find a hidden challenge area with a scrolling wall of death, a mini-boss encounter, and two more spheres to collect. It all adds up to one of the most comprehensive uses of Kirby's copy abilities yet, and while the adventure will only take you about 8 hours, there are incentives to play through again, so depending on how much of a completionist you are, you could easily double that time. Time always flies faster when you're playing with friends, though, which is why Return to Dreamland supports 4-person multiplayer. Friends can easily drop in or drop out at any time, but there are a couple catches. If any newcomers die, all they need to do is join again to continue the fight, but if player 1 bites the dust, then the entire group has to start over from the last checkpoint. You also share the same lives pool, so if one person is weighing down the others, it can be very easy to start getting resentful. Still, having characters tag along that always carry a slashing or smashing power is a boon to collectible hunting, and the addition of one person of even moderate skill makes boss battles almost too easy. It requires you to be a bit of a sheep herder at times, but the multiplayer is a great addition to an already solid gaming package. Return to Dreamland is some of the best of what Nintendo's gluttonous little marshmallow has to offer. The new twists on the powers are a blast to try out the whole way through, and with a couple friends, it gets even better. Couple that with Nintendo's classic colorful worlds and stunning level design, and you have one of the best titles on the Wii this year. Its length may turn some people off, but if you want a title that's so fun, you won't mind playing through it multiple times just for the sake of doing so, look no further.